Hey, what's going on, guys? Lansing here. Wanted to do a very quick video about the top five names that I use to help take my e-skate experience up a notch. And because budget is always something I know that is on my mind when I'm purchasing things, the list is going to have things that are very reasonably priced, and you're not going to see things on here which are like common sense, like a helmet and elbow pads and knee pads. I want it to be a little bit different. So the first thing that I use that really helps take my e-skate to another level is I put TileMates on all of my remotes. And if you're a skater, you know that there have been many times where you probably have tried to walk out the door and like, man, where is my remote? And you're looking for the remote, or especially if you have multiple boards and you have all these different remotes going on. So I threw the Tile on here because not only does it help me locate my remote, I can ping it and ring it and I can hear where it is. But then the other thing is, let's say you have multiple boards, a lot of different boards and remotes, you can actually set each tile, like you can have 2, 3, 4, 5 different tiles and say, okay, this tile is for this board, this tile is for that board. So this thing has been really effective in helping me when it's time to get out the door to find my remote quickly and know where my remote is. So I love that product right there. Another thing that, number two, which is this thing here, which is allows you to turn one outlet into multiple outlets. And if you've done any group riding, I'm sure you've run into the time where you guys are chilling, hanging out, charging up the boards, having a drink, a beer, a burger, whatever it is that you do, and there's not enough outlets. And I'm the kind of person, some people bring power strips, but to me, when I ride, I like to try to ride as light as possible. So this thing right here allows me to let three guys plug up if we need to plug up our boards. So to me, this is non-negotiable right here. It's really inexpensive. You can get this almost anywhere, Walmart, whatever the case may be. So that's like my number two item. I love this thing. It's come in handy many, many, many a times. All right. The third thing that has been incredibly effective with me is my JBL speaker. And this speaker has served a variety of different purposes. What I normally do is, this allows me to play my music while I'm riding and enjoy my music. And I normally have it in this case and I put it in here. And then when it's in here, I can click this on my bag or whatever the case may be, and I can hear my music while I'm riding, because I don't think it's very safe to have like earbuds in your ear while you're riding on your board. You need to hear your surroundings. The other thing that this does besides just allow you to play music is that oftentimes, like if I'm riding on a trail or something like that where there may be pedestrians walking, having this music makes them get out of your way. They hear the music and they're like, what is that? They turn around, they see you, and you can just kind of go around them. And what I found is that I don't always have to be like, on your left, on your right, right to your left. That gets annoying after a while, especially if you're passing a lot of different people. So that is another reason why this JBL speaker is awesome. And then finally, why it's awesome is like, if you have it pinned close to you, you can actually talk. Like if somebody calls you, you can answer the call and you can be talking to them real quick. If you want to say, hey, I'm riding real quick, I'll hit you back in a minute. So the JBL speaker has been great for me. No complaints whatsoever. Number four is having an extra remote. This is a true story. When I bought my very first board, the Wago 2S, I was so excited. And literally on the first day I was riding, I gave it to my son because he skates very well. He fell on it. He wasn't going fast at all. He had his pads on and everything. He fell and slammed the remote into the ground. And I was so worried that the remote was broken, because it takes, depending on where the board company, it might take weeks to get a spare part. So I'm like, oh my God, the very first day I get my board, the very first day I'm riding, he falls. I thought he smashed the remote, but he didn't. It actually survived the fall. But I immediately went out and ordered a second remote. The other thing I want to talk about is, this is one of my remotes that has the display on it. A lot of the newer modern boards are coming with it to show the odometer, the speed, the range, those different kind of things. These remotes are incredibly expensive. You go on the websites, they're $80, $90, $100 just because they have their display on there. But interestingly, because a lot of the boards use the Hobbywing ESC, and I think it was the Press Reset channel, he pointed it out first, you can use a cheaper Hobbywing remote at times if you need to. So what I do is I have a couple of these, so in case this one breaks or falls, you know, someone falls on it and they crack it or whatever the case may be, I still have another remote that I can use that's less expensive, because this Hobbywing remote It's like only like 25, 30 bucks, which is a great extra remote to have versus having to buy multiple of these that might be $80, $90. So that's another reason I love this, have one of these here. So I think everybody should have one of those as well, that extra remote setup. And it doesn't have to be maybe the stock expensive remote that's $90, $100. You might could be, if you're using Hobbywing, just jump over and get an expensive, another inexpensive version of the exact same Hobbywing remote and do your thing. The final thing that I want to talk about is bags. So when I'm riding, some might say, how are you carrying all of these different things when you're riding out? And how I do it is I ride with different bags. So oftentimes this is like the bigger bag. Let's say if I'm going on a longer ride and I might want to bring my battery, I might want to bring this thing here, I might want to grab, maybe even bring an extra remote or whatever the case may be, this thing comes in handy, or my skate tool, or you know, all the miscellaneous things that you may bring on a ride. This thing serves that purpose because it's a little bit bigger. And oftentimes what I'll do is, this is where I'll clip my speaker. So I'll have this on something like this, if I can get it on, and I'll be riding, and then I'll take this and I'll just clip it right in front of me so that I can hear the music when I'm riding pretty good. And then it's right in front of me. I can manipulate the buttons if I need to manipulate the buttons. So that's always something great as well. Another thing that I use is, let's say I'm riding and I can travel even lighter. I might just be going on a quick run with the guys. It's not like a long ride or something like that. Or I might just be riding by myself. I can take a smaller bag, kind of do the same thing, put this on, have this across my chest, or even put it on and have it kind of like that. But I can still carry some of the things that I may need, which could be my battery, which could be any other miscellaneous thing I need, my skate tool. So these are some inexpensive things that you can use that can kind of maybe take your e-skate experience to the next level. I'm gonna put links to everything that's in this video below. And all of these items are relatively inexpensive. Like, it's not gonna break the bank for you to be able to access these materials. One final note, guys, this is my new channel. I had to create another YouTube channel because I started to get a lot of traction on my other YouTube channel, but that's also like my personal page. And I wanted to create a page that was just dedicated to e-skate things, blogging and information like that. So if you like the content that was in the video, please consider taking a moment to just hit that subscribe button and maybe hit the bell. It'll help me out a lot. As always, I'll see you at the top because the bottom is too crowded. Peace.